Добре дошли на всички на първото представяне на наш партньор в чужбина, където топ-студенти от софтуерния университет ще могат да правят стажове или пък някои от тях може би да остават някоя друга година и да се върнат в София да направят девелопмент център заедно с тях. Аз съм ви разказвал отдавна за идеите, че искаме да осигурим на нашите студенти не просто качествено образование и професия, а най-важното работа и професионална реализация след това. И част от нашите така големи планове са да дадем достъп на софтуни студентите до работодатели като Facebook и Google, с които имаме предварителни разговори, успешни и което ще започне някъде около лятото. Паралелно виждам и варианти с други държави. Една от които е Германия, знаете, така най-силната икономика в Европейския съюз, където се пише здраво софтуер и където наистина се работи на ниво професионално. Днес имам удоволствие да представя една компания с 27 годишна история в автоматизация на производствените процеси. Това е фирмата ProLight от Германия, от Нюрнберг, където те се занимават с контрола на производствени и не само процеси в големи производства. Например, 20% от бирата на света, трябва ще да го кажат на вас, минава през техния софтуер. Така че всяка пета бира, която пиете, е минала през софтуера на ProLight. Тук са изпълнителният директор Волга и техническият директор Джозеф, т.е. представители на топ-екзекютив ниво, които ще ви разкажат за конкретно възможностите за стаж, които ще започнат след трето ниво. Или пък дай Боже да има някой бляскав студент, още от първо или второ ниво да успее да покрие изискванията или да блесне, защото естествено ще има подбори, интервюта и така нататък. С тях съм говорил толкова, давам думата на Волган да разкаже за ProLight и най-вече за стажовете, по какъв начин ще бъдат селектирани студентите, какво очаква Германия и цялата информация. Волган.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm really happy to be here today and to be able to present our company to you. It was in October last year when I got to know the first time about this great initiative you have here with the Software University, because all over the world we are really looking for good skilled software people, and so do we in ProLight. ProLight, which is a company which I founded together with my partner almost 29 years ago. I think this is before you all were born, when I looked into this room. I will tell you a little bit about ProLight and will let you know what we can offer you. And we decided after having known about the Software University first from Professor Nassauer in Munich, and then I met with Professor Nassauer and Dr. Koch. I think you know her, no? Most of you. And we decided to come here to present ourselves and to talk about the collaboration for the future we can have together with Software University, because I think this is a really great initiative, and I congratulate all of you that you have decided to study here and to get the skills to be a software developer in the future. So thank you very much for the invitation. I'm really happy to be here, and now I will tell you something about ProLight. ProLight is a German company which is now the technique is not working. Which is situated in the metropolitan region of Nuremberg. And I will tell you a little bit of the site of Nuremberg, of the metropolitan region, And Herzogenaurach, which is the city where we are located, it's close to Nuremberg. What makes the city unique? Then I will tell you a little bit about the company ProLight. What does ProLight, what offers ProLight? And then Joseph, which is the director of the development department, he will tell something about our process control system, which we developed the last 27 years, and the R&D department of ProLight AG. So what we offer is, for the first step, I think it will start in May or June, internships in Germany, and of course we are offering jobs in Germany, but we are also talking about in a longer future what we can do together here in Bulgaria. So this is not working. I have to do it like that. If you look on the map, you see here is Sofia, and up there, if you go by car 15 hours, Herzogenaurach. Herzogenaurach is a city, you may not know the name, but it has 23,000 inhabitants. It's close to Nuremberg, 20 kilometers, but if you tell you some of the big companies in Herzogenaurach, you will know them. Maybe not Ina Scheffler, which is the biggest one, but you will know Adidas and Puma, which have the headquarters in Herzogenaurach. Adidas and Puma, why the two big companies are in Herzogenaurach? It is an old story. These were two brothers and they founded a shoe company, and in the Second World War, one of the brothers was still a war prisoner and the other one was at home, and he started some relation with the other's wife, and then they had to separate and they founded two companies. One was Adidas and one was Puma. So this is the story in Herzogenaurach, which is very famous. The metropolitan region of Nuremberg is a wide region with 21,800 square kilometers. In the center we have Nuremberg, the capital of Franconia. This is the name of the region. Nuremberg has around 500,000 to 600,000 inhabitants. Then we have near Nuremberg, Erlangen. Erlangen may be known. It's the main city, the headquarters is in Munich, but the main city of Siemens, you know the company Siemens, the main part of Siemens after the Second World War was in Erlangen. Now they have also installments in Nuremberg. And Herzogenaurach is very close to Erlangen and Nuremberg. Also Fürth is a very important city. So we have a lot of bigger and smaller cities together, and this is a metropolitan region with a lot of companies. The population in this area around 3.5 million. So half of Bulgaria, no?
Yeah.
And Austria, I'm Austrian, so we have more or less the same population. We have 168,000 companies in this region, and about 1.9 million labor force people who have jobs there. And we have 20 universities and colleges. So this is a very important region. Beside Munich, of course, Munich is still more important, but beside Munich, which is also very expensive, I think the region around Nuremberg is very interesting. We have 93,000 students there, and well, the area is divided in 23 counties and 11 urban districts. The biggest of them is Nuremberg, then Fürth, Erlangen, Herzogenaurach, and many more. And a few impressions about Nuremberg. It's a very old city. It has the imperial castle where the emperor used to come there to have his, how to say in English, his meetings with his dukes. It has the very famous Christkindl market at Christmas. Then we have Erlangen. It's an old Huguenot town. The Huguenots came from France and they founded this city. And it's the university city. It's I think Erlangen just has two things. It has Siemens and it has university. So the other things are minor. And we have Fürth, which is also very famous. It has 2,000 historic buildings and so on. So it's a very old region, old buildings, very interesting things to see. And Herzogenaurach by itself, oh, the region, first, has a very nice landscape. It has natural parks in the metropolitan region, and you can do a lot of leisure things like hiking, canyoning, biking, climbing, and so on. Motorcycling is not here, but I love to motorcycle in this region. I'm from Austria. We don't say these are mountains. These are small mountains there, yeah, more or less hills, but it's very nice there for hiking, for motorcycling, cycling and so on. Now, if you look at Herzogenaurach, you see it's very close to Nuremberg. Here's the center of Nuremberg, and only 20 kilometers away is Herzogenaurach, with its, I think, 23 or 24,000 inhabitants now. And it's called the city of technology and sports. Of course, technology because of Ina Scheffler. Ina Scheffler is a big supplier for the car industry, and then the sports industry with Adidas and Puma. These are the well-known companies there. If you look from above the air photo, you see it's you see it better later in another photo, but it's also an old, very old city. In the year 2002, we had the 1,000 anniversary, 1,000 years anniversary in Herzogenaurach. It was a big celebration, of course. Now it's 1,012 years young. And it has approximately 24,700 inhabitants now. And what is important for Herzogenaurach, it's a very international city. So because of the big companies and the international companies, we have around 3,000 foreign citizens from about 100 nations. So if you go through Herzogenaurach, you will meet a lot of different people from a lot of different countries. It's very interesting to live there. And it has, I mean, we have less than 25,000 inhabitants, but we have 19,600 jobs. So this is a lot. And that means that a lot of people who live outside of Herzogenaurach can come to work to Herzogenaurach. So this is Ina Scheffler, the biggest company in Herzogenaurach, a big supplier for the automotive industry. Then we have Adidas, the new headquarters of Adidas in the former American barracks, when the American left Germany, Adidas bought all this area and put its new headquarters there. And we have the new building of Puma, which is very close to Adidas, so you can walk from one to the other company. And of course, we are not too big, but very important. Also an international company in the meantime, ProLight. ProLight, the company I founded together with my partner in 1986. A few more impressions about Herzog and Aurach. This is the old town festivals. We have a lot of festivals in Herzog and Aurach, so we can drink a lot of beer there, and it's very nice. During the summertime, you have every week, you have a festival in another village, you know, and some of them in Herzog and Aurach. The summer festival, and then we have the Middle Age, the medieval festival, where everybody is dressed like knights and from the old times. And we have, as I mentioned before, a lot of international people there in Herzog and Aurach. Yeah, and the facts of ProLight. My partner Manfred Czeppel and I, we were former Siemens employees, and we founded the company with two persons in 1986. And we offered to our customers process automation services. So our skills were process automation, programming PLCs, programming programmable logic controllers. And Joseph Buchsteiner was our first employee. He joined us October 86. And he is with us still since this time. It's almost 29 years now. And I know him from before. I know him since he's 5 years old, because he comes from the same village in Austria. And when I was in Germany and we founded the company, I told him, come here, I need you. And he came and he stayed with me. Today he is the head of the development department. From these two people from the very first beginning, we grew up to in between 345 employees worldwide, 256 of them in ProLight AG in Germany, 36 apprentices. We have a problem in Germany to get good skilled people, because in Germany we have practically no unemployment. And it's not sufficient only to wait for the universities or for the universities to bring enough skilled people for us. We have started to educate our own people, to skill our own people. And so we have 36 apprentices with us. The total output in 2013-2014, I have to put it a little bit more, 32 million euros. We have four branches. Oops, sorry. It's too fast. We have four branch offices in Germany. The headquarters are in Herzog and Aurach. We have other offices in Leverkusen, which is near Cologne. We have one in the east, Halle, and we have one in Hannover. And we have two people situated in Kitzingen, which is 70 kilometers from Herzog and Aurach, because there we have a partner, and we have two people sitting there to work close together with our partner. And we have nine international subsidiaries. The nine international subsidiaries are situated in these countries. First of all, in Europe, we started with Austria, Netherlands, and Spain. But we have offices in Russia, in Moscow, and in Kazan. We have an office in Ukraine. This is a little bit complicated at the moment. Director of Moscow is also the director of Ukraine, so it's a difficult situation. We have an office in Shanghai, in China, and we have offices in Brazil, near Sao Paulo, in Mexico, and in Chicago, in the United States. So we are from the very first beginning we were doing worldwide business, but our customers always said, okay, that's nice that you do the automation of our plant, but later on when we need support, we don't want to call Germany. Our users don't speak English so well, and sometimes the time zones are different. So we decided to put subsidiaries there, to put local people there. They can give the service to the customers in the local language, and they are closed. If something happens, they can arrive at the customer in a few hours. So this was necessary to serve the international customers and to be able to grow internationally. The scope of our business, I said before, we started with services of automation in the process industry. The process industry for us is the focus. What is the process industry? It's mainly the food industry. We are very strong in breweries. We automated worldwide breweries, and today we have around 20% of the world beer production which is automated by Prolat Solutions. So I think this is a very strong number. Other branches where we are working in is in the whole food industry, but mainly the dairies, also beverages, fruit juice, but also bakeries, and some fine chemicals which are detergents like washing powder and so on, and some pharmaceutical plants we have also automated. The project business is one strong part of our business. We go to the customer, we talk to the customer what he needs. If it is a greenfield project, he builds a new production plant, we discuss with the customer exactly the processes he has, and then we program these processes. We make the specification, we do all the engineering, all the software engineering, yeah, not the hardware engineering, not the building and so on. The software engineering, the configuration of the process control system for the whole plant, this we call horizontal integration. And from the PLC level, from the automation level up to the interface to the ERP system. So we have also the whole MES level, which we offer to the customer, and interface to the existing ERP system. Including the IT hardware and all the network, we offer that, but this we buy from our partners. And the second part is the system business. We started very early. We had the idea that we had to standardize our know-how, and we started very early to develop our own process control system. And over 27 years now, we developed several versions of this process control system, and we'll later on tell you a little bit more about that, which started on the process control level, but then developed also solutions for the production data management. We have a batch system, for example, and we have the MES, manufacturing execution system solutions. These are again the different branches we serve. Beverage industry, dairy industry, brewing industry, food industry, chemical industry, agro industry like animal feed and so on, and pharmaceutical industry. Some OEM partners are the plant suppliers which supply all the vessels and the valves and so on. We work together with them. And then a few of our customers, you can find more on our webpage. Who is interested later on, I have here a media card. There is a username and a password, and with this username and password you can have access to all our informations on our webpage, which not everybody has access to. Yeah. So with this you get access to much more informations. So these are some of our most important references in Bruges here. And then various food and beverage, pharmacy and chemistry. You may know some of them, international companies, German companies. And this is our process control system. Two names, one system for the brewing industry. We established an own brand label, it's called Brewmax, but it's at least it's the same software, it's the same core software, but yeah, it's just marketing. And Plant IT, which is the name, the general name of our software product family. Our process control systems are currently used in over 1,400 plants. So in 29 years you can do a lot of projects, and over the years you gain a lot of installations. And in more than 100 countries. As I said, Brewmax is the planted industry solution for the breweries. This is Warsteiner. You may know the beer, the German beer Warsteiner. We did the whole automation of the Warsteiner brewery. Yeah, it's 20% of the world beer production is done with our process control system. And this is the timeline of the development of our system. You see, we started several times with a new development because of new technologies coming up. At the beginning we started only with a PLC with some additional memory and semi-graphical interfaces. So this was a very old-fashioned technology.
Not at that day,
it was very modern, but for you today it's a very old-fashioned technology. Then we started with the first PCs, we started with MS-DOS, then with Windows NT, and over the years we had to develop several times the system with new operating systems and with new databases and so on. And also from the functionality, we started with process control level only, and then over the years with data acquisition, with only MES level, tracking and tracing, and the interface to the ERP system. And then we said, the first years our process control system was working with the PLCs of Siemens. This was sufficient for the European market. But we wanted to go also to the American market, and in America Siemens is not so strong. American markets are dominated by Rockwell, Allen Bradley, and we developed a new version which is a multi-platform version, and in the moment we are focusing on Siemens and Rockwell. We could add other platforms if necessary, but in the moment we reach about 60% of the world market with only these two PLC suppliers. So at the moment this is sufficient for us, but we want to do more in developing the MES functions, and there we need to ramp up our staff. We have in the moment around 20 pure developers, and as you saw, 350 people in total. Most of them are doing the customizing the services for the customer. But we want to wrap up the pure developer department from 20 to at least 40 or 50 people in the next 3-4 years. So we are really looking for good, skilled people to join us, or in Germany, or we are also thinking about maybe outsourcing something, and maybe Bulgaria could be for us a good fit to have a hub to offshore some of our development tasks. Yeah, maybe this I will show it in an overview, but later on Joseph will tell a little bit more about the system itself and the background of the system. But if you see the different levels in a company, the control level, the MES level, and the ERP level, these are our products in this product family with the plant directed, the process control system with two different technologies. The liquid is more for the breweries, for the liquid processes, and the batch, it is a batch system, the recipe management system for batch processes, which is more for the solid processes. Then we have the acquisition, which is the data acquisition system, or part of the system, integrated. The material management, it's very important to manage also the material in the processes. And then the plant that connects the interface manager to several ERP systems above. So this vertical integration is very important in the productions, that you get the planning data from the ERP system down to the process control system, and the production data and all the data which is generated in the production up to the ERP system via the MES system again. Therefore, you need a horizontal integration. We tell the customer today, you need an automation from one hand, from the raw material intake to the outtake of the real, of the ready product, of the finished product, and then you can integrate everything in the vertical way up to the ERP system. Yeah. The newest version, which came out last year, is the version 9. And you see some screens here. Joseph will tell a little bit more about that. This is the interface for the user. The user has to see what happens in his plant. He doesn't control the plant by himself. He starts a recipe. Let's say he says, I want to produce pills 100 hectoliter. Yeah? And the rest is done by the process control system. But he has to see what is going on in the plant, and whenever there is something which is not correct, he can interfere and react and correct. And therefore he has to see what is going on in the system. And of course you can imagine there is a lot of software behind it, because we are controlling very, very huge production plants with several thousand actors and sensors. And the processes in there are very complex. Yeah? And the process control system has to make a complex plant and a complex process easy to use for the user, for the one who has to control the system. So this is the screen designer, how you can design the plant in the system. MES with some slides to show the data. Yes, and now I will hand over my microphone to Joseph, because he's the expert in the more technical things. The last time I was programming something was in 1995, so I'm far out of the thing. Okay, thank you very much. I hand it over to you.
Welcome also from my side. As Wolfgang introduced me already, my name is Josef Buchsteiner, and I'm also very long at the Kulat company, since 29 years now. And in the meantime, since 7 years already, I'm the head of the Department of Development and Software Research. And you saw the pictures before, where Kulat has its building. This building is very close to our Kulat buildings, just 50 meters on the right side. And on the sixth floor, we rent some offices for the development and three other departments from Kulat, because of the increasing of the business, we need more people, and our space in our own buildings was too less, therefore we rent something here. So this is the sixth floor where our offices are. An impression how it looks like from inside. You see there was a coffee bar, corridor, and this is a typical office where my developers doing their daily job. The organization of the development department, actually, I myself, head of the department, and is split it in different groups. As you saw on the slides before, we have in our product the process control platform system. This is the right side. There are two teams, one for the core development and one for the technology parts, which is the batches, the liquid, and the directed, the technological parts of the process control system. And the younger product family is the manufacturing execution system, the MES, the plant integrate. And here the technology is a little bit different. This is more, let's say, a web-based application or system, because the process control system, you saw it on the slides before, is designed for a FAT client. The user interface is more or less with C#, .NET, and WPF in the latest version. And for maybe you remember the control room from the Warsteiner Brewery. In this environment, a FAT client up today is a very accepted standard for our customers. For the MES systems, it's completely different. The use of the MES systems are not the operators for the production plant, or not only. This is typically one level higher, and sometimes distributed over different places if the company is bigger. Then they want to have access from their office or from at home to monitor their reports and watch their KPIs. And for that reason, a FAT client, of course, is not a good idea. And so the architecture is here, web-based. And this is that part of development where hopefully one or two or three of you can join us in the first step. This is the most increasing part in my department where I need additional resources. And then, of course, some services in the development department, a responsibility for the setup development. In the former years, it was done from a developer. At the end of the development cycle, he did the setup and then makes it sellable and distributable. But the cycle is accelerating. Microsoft is accelerating with the new releases of their operating systems. We ourselves have to accelerate our development and release process, and the task for the development of the setup is a full-time job for one developer. And this was established last year. The software test, of course, important for the quality things, very important as an extra team. I have a small team with two, three guys for documentation, doing the manuals, they're doing the translation of the user interfaces and things like that. This is one responsibility. Since a few years, we established a small team, actually only small, but it's also important, and maybe increasing team for usability engineering. You saw the history of our development, very long. We are driven from engineers and more technical requirements, and things are getting complexer and complexer and bigger. And so the need was to focus a lot more on usability and on design. So we did this with dedicated usability engineers. And that do really, as it is foreseen, the classical usability engineering processes with interviews and test scenarios, and maybe you know that from your business. Yeah, and the licensing and the delivery is also an important task. If a customer orders a package, it's more, also everything is complex in our world, it's important to check if somebody needs an installation, which license, which components, the package together with the Microsoft license, the SQL Server license, with the user calls, and so on. So there is a person in the development who is responsible for dealing with this licensing process and delivering of the software. Yeah, actually we are 22 people in the development. Wolfgang told before we are planning to increase this manpower up to 40 or 50 developers, or the complete team within the next years. Our environment, we replaced our former system against the Microsoft Team Foundation server. We did that last year. Actually, we model our development process with that. This is supported very good with the Team Foundation server. It supports with the reporting, with the planning, progress control and everything with the Team Foundation server, the version control and the build process. The typical environment for the developer is a Visual Studio Professional. For the usual languages, as a database, we work with the Microsoft SQL Server 2014 today. In the MES environment, is more important in the back end to deal with the SQL Server. SQL, transactional SQL, is the most used or necessary skill in the backend, in the MES backend, together with the reporting services to deal with that, and the integration services for this internal workflows for the extract, transform, and load process. We are using this Microsoft integration services. Operating system, everything is Microsoft in our environment. And of course, last but not least, the lowest level from the slides, you always see this on the lowest position, the programmable controllers from Siemens, the 7400. There is a program language called Step 7, and the pendant from the to the Rockwell is the RS Logix 5000. This is a specific language and programmable situation. It's a little bit different to that what we are used to on the PC. But this is also part of the development. We have to work with that. Yeah, what is our plan for the next month? So let's say this next year, roughly, not in too much details. In the process control system, we have to redesign the engineering environment. On one slide before, it was the entry point to the screen designer. It's an C++ and C sharp and partly in Visual Basic matured and grown framework for the engineering of the system, and this needs to be redesigned and redeveloped as the next big major development in the process control system. Actually, we are preparing with the usability engineers the preparation, the navigation concept, and things like that with our colleagues, with the users, and doing interviews and tests and workshops to get the experience and the needs and the wishes and the ideas of our existing users, how they would like to have it more efficient. The goal here is to reduce the engineering time which our colleagues and our customers are working with the system to be more competitive in compared with other solutions. Of course, it saves our lives, it saves our business, and this is one of the goals here. The rest is more or less here daily business. Siemens came out with a new controller. We have to consider that. We have to modify the PLC software that it can run on the new versions, some enhancements on existing systems, which are requirements from some important big customers, whatever. There are two, three modifications we have to do in this year, and some enhancements in the core system. In the MES, I told before, this is the youngest child. There is no history, there is nothing to replace or nothing to make new. There is a lot to make new, to create new content, new websites, new front ends. We started with the web portal. Responsive design and things like that are important here. Some examples what's on the list already. And here is also the plan to support the mobile devices and invest here a lot in the future. This will be the most growing part in the development. Yeah, so far from the development. Thank you very much.
So you see, we have a lot to do in our software development, and if I hope many of you are interested in that direction of software development, in a direction which is technology driven and really in a process solves problems in processes. As I said, I have the media card where you can get more information from our webpage. You can read some case studies, projects we did with some technical details. I have also here my business cards. If you have later on questions, you can always send me an email. And I have brought some giveaways. Fortunately, you are much more people than I have giveaways. This means that you are very interested. Unfortunately, I don't have giveaways for everybody. So if somebody doesn't get something and wants it, please send me an email and I will send it to you. So now we are, of course, also willing to answer your questions now, or if you want, you send me an email and I answer the questions later on, or I forward it to the people which are able to answer the questions. As I said before, the last year I did programming by myself was in 1995, so I'm a little bit away now from the techniques and the technical questions. I will forward to Joseph or to one of his specialists. So thank you very much, and if you have questions, please ask.
I have a question.
Please.
If some of us make it to the next steps, interviews, what are the projects that you intend to work with us during the internships?
I think this will be some projects around the web portal. We'll integrate through in my team who is developing web pages in our MES program. Or maybe something in the mobile area for Android or iOS. This could also be an option. This is not not defined yet. But it will be in the MES area and something with the user interfaces on web-based
It depends also a little bit on your preferences. So we are a little bit flexible in what you can do.
But it should be, of course, it should be something which is interesting for you, and it should be, of course, a benefit for us, for me. That what you produce in your time in our company, that we can use that, of course. Yeah? So I would like to integrate you somehow in the web team, in the MES team, and not.
That's not true.
If some of you is willing or like to develop something in the backend, maybe this is also an option. But I see you priority in the MES area, because there we have the most need to create new stuff. And there's the biggest chance, and there is. I think the time to get you productive the lowest. On the process control system, which is more matured and more monolith, much more dependencies from the front end to the back end and database, you have to have more experience and know how it works everything together to can develop something productive in that area. In the web area, I think the time to get a productive is much shorter.
And secondary question, what are the most important qualities that you feel that us, the developers, should have if we want to work together?
From the skills? From the
yeah, what do you feel like it's important, like skills, personality, or how do you define your development?
on the slide for the web contents from the skills, what I saw here from Risto is I think that what you learn here. It's JavaScript, HTML5 and CSS3. But I think everything what's here is well known here. We decided before Christmas to go with jQuery and UI. What is in the architecture, the background used, this is maybe you have heard about that, is the OData interface to have it as maximum as possible separated from the front end to the business logic in the back end to be prepared to be flexible and able to use the backend for all different front ends and then platforms, maybe what in future will come.
And of course,
the architecture is designed and it's working, but nevertheless, I'm sure we have to fill something also in the backend. We have the ASP.NET, MVC. The service actually, this is what is mostly used for the most pages. And if you can help us around here somewhere, or if there is a need, welcome, of course. But also maybe on the front end side only.
And from the personality, of course, this is teamwork. We are a team. We work. We develop together with 22 people, and you should be a team worker and not somebody who only wants to work alone. And English is sufficient, but you should learn to order a beer in German.
That you develop. I mean, is it this Square setup development team? Are there persons from the developers that implement the solutions in industrial?
No. The development team is developing the system, and then we have implementation teams in our company, and also we have partners which are implementing the system on the customer side.
Which is not shown.
Which is not shown here.
This is only, yeah,
this is only the development part. Mm. So in the company we have several departments, one for breweries, one for dairies, one for food industry and chemical industry. And also our subsidiaries worldwide are implementing the software in the customer's
plans. The handover is from the licensing and delivery. Yeah. Okay. This is the handover to the other departments and they get a CD or a DVD.
If you want to implement the system at the customer side, you need more know-how and technology. So for example, if you want to implement it in a brewery, you need to know how a brewery works, you know, because you have to parameterize the whole system. You have to parameterize every valve, every motor and pump and so on. And then you have to know the processes. You have to program the sequences, what shall happen in what sequence and so on. You have to know how the beer production processes work. Yeah.
I've been working in chocolate
for 5 years.
So.
Okay, so you could do it. I mean, there we are also looking for people. I just didn't expect anybody here with knowledge in that area.
Just wanted to know the split of responsibilities for the teams.
The batching solution would fit to a chocolate fabric.
Yeah. Oh, we did some chocolate factories. Linz Brunli in Switzerland, for example. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And because every one of you may ask about what are the next steps, how you can enroll in this program, we will publish at our website after month maybe or two, when we are ready. The entire concept of this internship program, and also we'll have a presentation for all the companies because we want to have several partners abroad, not only provide but even more companies, and you will apply just like a job ad. You put your application and the best candidates are sent to Germany and are preliminary approved, then some phone call interviews will pass, and then some other arrangements like conditions, travels, accommodation, tickets. There is no visa for Germany, but things like that. We are just we're developing this direction of exchanging students with German companies, and this is the start, and we congratulate ProLife for becoming our first such partner for providing challenging jobs in the real industry.
And for coming personally also.
And for coming personally, the CEO of such a large company is here, it's not the HR. The CTO, yeah, typically at this event, people say the HR.
Can you ask me, I'll switch to Bulgarian tourists. Бих те ли, ние все още говорим и виждаме как да направим нещата по най-умния начин и по най-удобния начин за вас. Госпожа Полк, която е всъщност нашия приятел, който работи с така, че софтуерен университет може да работи с някакви компания в Германия. Все още не знаем точно как точно ще го направим, но сега се опитам да ви кажа, че в следващите 1-2 месеца ние ще публикуваме някаква точна информация, кога ще бъдат стъпките, какви ще бъдат стъпките. А просто искам да направим една такава презентация, за да видите самите хора, които го правят, какво може да се очаква от тях. Както виждате, вече действаме с български компании, с работа в самия университет и с компании, които са в Германия, като Германия е основния двигател на програма. Целта ни е в рамките на 1-2 месеца да може да покажем наистина конкретна информация. Тя най-вероятно ще бъде за студентите, които ще извършат сега модул 3, който сега започва в Хуай. Те ще се запълнили всъщност през първите, които ще са направили една пълна година с нас, но базирайки се на тяхното желание, първо вашето желание, ако искате, просто ще се направи нещо като някакъв шортлист. Ние също го правим за първи път. Целта ни е да пробваме с около 10 човека, 5 до 10 човека, които имат желание, които ние ще се постараем от наша страна да направим максимално най-прост процеса, но там вече ние действаме с самите компании. Имате, ако ви харесате, може да останете там, може да се продължите тук. Това вече си е вашия път. Така че, може би още малко търпение, ще може да вървим много по-точно по тази за нас.
Thank you again for your great interest and please serve yourself here with the media cards.
First come, first serve.
Който превари, има наградки, готини са.